Black Ops 4 has quite a list of weapons, and although these weapons are statistically similar in some ways, they can differ quite a bit per weapon in other ways. The in-game statistics will rate the weapons on a scale from 1 to 20, but it doesn't give you any reliable information. Rather, it gives an approximation of the weapon stats. In this video, we'll dive deeper into all the stats for each weapon, starting with the Rampart 17, the high-damage, fully automatic assault rifle that resembles the SCAR-H. Before starting, in this weapon guide we will talk about the stats of the weapons, from damage and range to idle sway and ADS time. The footage and stats are based on in-game testing for multiplayer, but not Blackout. Stats will differ between the modes according to the deaths, but it's hard deaths in Blackout, so we won't be including them for Blackout now. If you're interested in the stats for Blackout, let us know and we'll consider adding them. Rating the video, commenting and sharing helps the promotion of these guides, and let us know there's a demand for it out there, because we spend a lot of time making these guides. Alongside these videos, I will upload blueprints of the weapons and their stats on Patreon. It's for those who are interested in being able to have a look at the build without rewatching the video again. These are one among many rewards for our patrons, so if you're willing to support us monetarily, that's what you get in return. Helping me today is my test dummy. What's up? Starting with the most important statistic, the base damage on the Rampart 17. It has the highest damage in class, with a damage of 46 HP per bullet until a range of approximately 50 meters. From 50 meters on, it instantly drops to 37 HP per bullet, and that range can be almost doubled, however, using the long barrel. The long barrel increases the optimal range to roughly 29 meters, making this a great attachment, but you won't engage too many opponents at that range, meaning you're better off spending your points towards another attachment. Its headshot damage is not that much higher than the base damage, at only 50 HP per bullet. With this base damage and headshot damage, it manages to kill any opponent in 3 to 4 bullets, which is high for the assault rifles. A side note here is that these shots to kill exclude the use of FMJ, high caliber and armor. Where this weapon really sets itself apart from the other assault rifles is when adding high caliber. High caliber 1 increases the headshot damage to 59 HP per bullet. High caliber 2, however, also increases the damage to the upper body to 59 HP per bullet, so not only the head. This can turn it from a 3 to 4 bullet kill into a reliable 3 bullet kill, even when not shooting someone in the head, need I say more. But every so often the opponent is wearing body armor. This reduces the Rampart 17's damage by 50%, down to 23 HP per bullet, meaning it will be a 5 bullet kill. Selecting FMJ1 will increase the damage to its normal 46 HP per bullet, and results in a 4 bullet kill again, as it instantly destroys the armor. FMJ2, however, has no increased effect against body armor compared to FMJ1. However, it increases the cover penetration by a little bit, making it useful for wall banging. Although the damage is high, its rate of fire is quite low in comparison to the other assault rifles. It shoots at roughly 550 rounds per minute. This reduces the time to kill quite a bit, which is what we'll call balance. Besides damage range and rate of fire, the handling is the third most important factor in our time to kill. Starting with its ADS time, or the time it takes to aim down sights and for the crosshairs to disappear. It takes 0.08 seconds to ADS and fire our gun from a stationary position. And funnily enough, the time it takes from sprinting to aiming down the sights and firing is 0.08 seconds too. Aiming down the sights is more accurate than hip fire. However, the weapon has quite a lot of idle sway. Idle sway, or simply sway, is the sight moving around when aiming down sight. It's not measurable in a number, but on screen we can see the radius and pattern of the sway. It's medium across the board, but high for assault rifle. This is one of the features that it can be improved on. The next most important stat is the recoil, or what in-game is called accuracy. As can be seen on screen, it has high recoil. It starts with vertical kick, then kicks to the right, returns to the center, only to kick upwards again. Knowing this pattern makes predicting the recoil easier. Obviously, using a grip improves the accuracy, but on this weapon, it hardly reduces the recoil. You can see that its vertical kick is a little less, but it's not significant enough to make it a viable attachment. This means we're better off selecting another attachment. The hipfire spread isn't something to brag about either. We can't put it into a number, but on screen you can see the spread while standing, crouching and proning. While average for the assault rifles, it's smarter to aim down the sights. Keep in mind that this can change depending on our stance, as we can see the spread getting smaller when crouching or proning. Movement speed with the Rampart 17 is similar to the other assault rifles at 90%. Strafing without ADSing moves us at 90% of our walking speed, similar to walking and running. Strafing while ADSing is worse for our mobility, however, and will slow us down significantly to about 50%. This will hurt our ability to dodge incoming fire, so using cover is of importance with this weapon. Submachine guns will definitely outperform us on this run, so don't challenge them in close ranges if you don't have to. Moving on to the magazine size, it has a basic magazine size of 30 rounds. It can't equip an extended magazine, only a fast magazine. Since it doesn't have a high rate of fire, we won't be running out of bullets quickly. However, if we want to go on a streak, we might want to equip a scavenger, as it only has two spare magazines for a total of three. Its reload time is fairly average again, maybe even a little bit on the slow side, with it only taking 1.2 seconds for the magazine to be loaded in, but for the total reload time it takes 3.04 seconds. That is quite long for the total reload to complete, meaning we're vulnerable for a long time. The Fastmax attachment reduces this by 50%, meaning it will be a 1.52 second reload, which isn't half bad. So with the information we have, there are some clear recommendations. We'll set up our Rampart 17 with high caliber 1 and 2, FMJ 1, and while it has clear iron sights, I prefer the holographic sight on it. Although it lacks accuracy, the grip doesn't provide any significant improvements, so we don't recommend that. Fastmax will be a viable option here as well, since the reload is pretty slow. The specialist of choice should either be Seraph or Nomad, since their abilities have natural synergy with the playstyle required when using this weapon. By that I mean we can control sightlines and chokes from medium range. Recommended perks are Scavenger, Dexterity and Tracker, for similar reasons as the choice of Specialist. Top it off with Stimshot to instantly bring yourself to full health and reducing the medkit cooldown. Alternatively, using the acoustic sensor could help locating enemies that try to flank, but I don't have much success with it, to be honest. So it's up to you. Regarding strategy, as far as there is any in Black Ops 4, engage enemies at medium range, mostly focusing sidelines and chokes. Up close, this weapon is outperformed by submachine guns and other assault rifles. However, if we happen to run into an opponent, start hipfiring first and continue this into ADS. Aim towards their upper part of the body to maximize our time to kill, and keep track of the recoil pattern. As we saw, it tends to go upwards and to the right, then center and upwards again, in that order. Counter this by pulling down and aiming a little to the left. Use this to optimize the use of this weapon and go kick some ass. That concludes the weapon guide for the Rampart 17, at the moment my favorite weapon to use in Black Ops 4. I appreciate you taking the time out of your day to watch this content. If you made it this far, consider leaving a rating, good or bad, doesn't matter. It provides us feedback so we'll know if there's a demand for these weapon guides or not. Comment down below with your Rampart 17 setup. What attachments, specialist, equipment and perks do you use? Before ending the video, here's a quick reminder. For those interested in being able to have a look at the build without rewatching the video again, I designed blueprints of the gear, weapon, skills and talents. They're available on Patreon, among other rewards, for those who are willing to support us monetarily. The specifics can be found on Patreon, so hopefully I'll see you there. Have a good day, and peace out.